All right, guys, we're on a no cooling call. Ooh, I can see a big old oil stain on that microchannel. I knew this thing was leaking. She must have got some dirt hauled in back here. Yeah, it comes on. It is a 4-ton. Let's see if there's any Freon in it. It's 410A. What kind of suction pressure we got? -86. The head pressure. They put the high side on there. So guys, I know that this unit leaks. It leaks out here on the microchannel and it leaks inside. I think she wants me to go ahead and add Freon to it. Nine, 212 over 92. 211 over 92. Compressor doesn't sound that great. It doesn't need much. My compressor sounds horrible. So I have this Appion charging tee. Install right there. And we'll put the probe here. Actually, you know what? We'll put the probe in the back. I can work my ball valve from the top of it. Now we'll go get some 410A and a hose and maybe a scale, or I'll just weigh it before I bring the jug back here. All right, so I've got my hose there on the top of that T. Let me get my phone out. Boy, this compressor is just winding. It's, I don't know if y'all can hear that, but it sounds horrible. Let me reset the field piece app because I walked away from it. There we go. Suction pressure actually came up a little bit. Okay, we got the pressure up to 111, got it above freezing. I don't know if y'all can hear that compressor, but it's just going, I mean, it's bad. There it goes. Spoken to her several times about needing a change out. She doesn't need a new electric furnace. This is a mobile home. Her electric furnace is fine. She needs a coil and a condenser. Yeah, I'm the one that put that disconnect on there, I believe. I think her other one was fried. Right? Pulling heat, I got the super heat down to 20, 19, got the saturation at almost 40. Yeah, there goes that compressor again. Compressor's getting loud, I think I'm gonna stop. Yeah, super heat's down to 17, I'm gonna stop right there. Weighed my jug before I came and did this. Just what was left over in my hose, guys. Don't freak out.